Hi everyone, welcome to the RPB Resonance Chemistry. Now we have discussed another important lecture in palladium catalyzer and new CSR single bond reaction. So which are CSR net advanced named reaction. Okay, now here this is the Sonagashira coupling reaction, Sonagashira cross coupling reaction. So now the general definition regarding to the Sonagashira cross coupling reaction is the direct cross coupling of a terminal alkyne with the aryl halides. So the direct cross coupling of terminal alkyne with the aryl halides or aryl triplets in the presence of catalytical amounts of palladium PPH3 four times catalyst or palladium PPH3 like taking twice at Cl2 and using cuprous iodide as a co-catalyst, cuprous iodide as a catalyst in amine solvents. Okay, now here, so two catalysts, one is palladium as well as copper. So palladium, copper as well as amine solvents only, like butylamine, propylamine, like such type of amine solvents. So this is the overall reaction regarding to the Sonagashira. Okay, generally, so the general representation of Sonagashira is alkyl halide, which is treated with terminal alkynes. So this is the terminal alkyne representation. Alkyl halides or alkyl triplets or tosylates, it doesn't matter. So which are treated with terminal alkynes in the presence of palladium catalyst, palladium PPH3 four times, or like copper iodide as a co-catalyst, copper one salt, that is copper iodide as a co-catalyst. Now it gives their new CC single bond at sp carbon and sp3 carbon. Now here it creates the new CC single bond at sp3 and sp carbon. In general reaction, sp3 sp3 bond is formed. In egg reaction, sp2 sp bond is formed. Now here sp3 new CC single bond is formed, sp3 new CC single bond. So now here it is the terminal alkyne. So generally terminal alkyne treated with copper iodide, it gives their terminal copper product, cuprated product, which is eliminated by the hydrogen iodide. These groups involves in the transmetallation step to give them their alkyne groups to the palladium catalyst, which are discussed over there, like catalytical mechanical pathway. Now here, this is the simplest reaction regarding to the Sonagashira, but it includes several limitations. Okay, now let us discuss those limitations. Okay, now here, this is the terminal alkyne. Whenever we use those type of reagents, palladium reagents like amine salts, butyl amine. Okay, but now we will get the product like this. Okay, it seems to be like a self-coupled product. Self-coupled, that means auto-coupled product. So whenever the presence of oxygen, the first limitation, the presence of oxygen O2, so now it gives a self-coupled instead of a new CC single bond formation reaction. So the presence of oxygen, it gives a self-coupled reaction instead of a new CC single bond formation. That is the first limitation. Now let us discuss the second limitation. Here, in this case of Sonagashira couplings, copper iodide taken as a small quantity. In small quantity. Okay, now the third one, that is terminal position of alkyne can only give coupling reaction. So these are the main limitations regarding to the Sonagashira cross coupling reaction. Now again, another point is also very important, that is butyl amine solvents. So simply amine solvents which are used in the Sonagashira coupling, amine solvents. So now here it is a palladium copper catalyzed, like a double catalyzed palladium copper catalyzed new cis single bond formation from like terminal alkynes and organohalo or organotriflate compounds, which is called sonagesira. This is the simplest representation. Now let us discuss the mechanical Tolman cyclization pathway of the sonagesira cross coupling reaction. Now we was looked out the Tolman cyclization pathway of the sonagesira coupling reaction. Now here it is palladium LN. That means now I would like to write over here palladium LN. Okay. Now here after the ligand dissociation, 2 moles of ligand dissociation, it gives palladium L2. So now here oxidation state is 0. So in this case, whenever we add the alkyl halide, it becomes RxL2. That is called oxidative addition. This is the first step. It has oxidative addition. So oxidative addition followed by the like cis-2 trans isomerization. Palladium like a ligand here R, here X. So after this cis-2 trans isomerization, we will add the our RC triple bond C copper. So copper containing alkane. So generally, so here it is the terminal alkane. So which is treated with copper iodide, like a small quantity of copper iodide. Now it becomes RC triple bond copper. So copper cuprated alkane. So now here the presence of cuprated alkane. Now here a transmetallation takes place. Generally, transmetallation is the key step, that is a slow step. Now here we will get the copper halide, again palladium R, here it is the triple bond R dash. Let us assume it is R dash. Now here ligand. So thereafter simply it is, first of all here cis-2 trans isomerization takes place. Now here trans-2 cis isomerization takes place. Now we will get the palladium ligand. Here it is the R, here it is the triple bond R dash. So finally, so by using the reductive elimination R2C triple bond C R dash. So here the reductive elimination, we will get our catalyst as a regenerated. So regeneration takes place. This is the catalytical loops of the sonagesira cross coupling reaction. Now here it is the first step, second step, third step, fourth step, that is D. This is the fifth step. So generally first step is oxidative addition. So in this step here, the oxidation state 0 to 2, again coordination number 2 to 4. So the increment of 2 units of like oxidation state as well as coordination number, that is oxidative addition. Second step, now here the movement of reaction, that means rate of reaction enhances. Now here with the help of cis-2 trans isomerization, these trans compound will give them a more rapidly transmetallation reaction. Now here it is a cis-2 trans isomerization. Now in third step, here it is the transmetallation. Now alkyne group transferred from copper to palladium. Transmetallation. So now the fourth step is like a trans-2 cis isomerization. Now the final step is reductive elimination. So these 5 steps, which are basically involved in the sonagesira catalytical mechanical pathway, of the sonagesira reaction. So generally, so terminal alkanes which are treated with alkyl halides or organohalides or organic triflates will give the like a new cis single bond, that is sp3 sp new cis single bond will be formed. So this is the simplest reaction as well as the mechanism about the sonagesira cross coupling reaction. Now let us go through the some of the examples regarding to the sonagesira cross coupling. Now we solve some of the problem regarding to the sonagesira coupling reactions. So here the mainly terminal alkyne which are connected to the alkyl halides or triflate compounds, alkynyl or alkyl or aryl, whatever the name. Okay. Now here triflate carbon, triflate attached carbon or halogen attached carbon, which are connected to the like a triple bond, that is called a terminal alkane. Terminal alkane. Now here, so this is the R group, R dash I. So this is the like a C triple bond, like a terminal RH, terminal RH. In presence of a palladium, copper iodide as a co-catalyst. Now it will use the RCC triple bond like this. This is the general representation regarding to the like a personal acid couple. Now here R is equal to the group. This is the alkene, which has a C5H11. So which is connected to the like our triple bond, C triple bond C. Now here CH2CH2OH. So this is the first example product. This is the first example product. And again, here one point is I was missed out in general basics. So this reaction time is 3 to 5 hours only. 3 to 5 hours under 25 degree centigrade temperature. So maybe plus 2 or minus 2. Okay. Now here the reaction time is very less, 3 to 5 minutes. That's why these reactions are very easier reaction to carry out our general conditions with the help of amine solvents. With the help of amine solvents. Okay. Now let us think about like a second problem. Here it is the triflate, alkenyl triflate, which are treated with a like terminal compound. Now here it gives the like a similar C triple bond C4H9. Here it is the tertiary butyl group. Here it is the tertiary butyl group. Now the third one in the same case, so palladium plus 2. So in many of the cases, instead of a palladium 0, we will take the palladium 2, that gives more stable than that of the palladium 0. That's why we will take the like many of the example. Here it is the palladium 2. So here which group are replaced by the triple bond, that is a terminal alkyne. So first of all, it will convert it like this. Then here the copper triflate is eliminated. Now here it forms the corresponding alkyne. So here which tolerates all type of functional groups. Now here it is COOethyl in the previous cases, so like olefins. In previous cases, so like alcohols. So such type of groups are tolerated. Now here, so NH2 iodine. So even though here it is a more basic, more acidic protons. Now here, which is not affected, will give the like similar type of product. Triple bond SiMe3. Here it is the NH2. Here almost all like 80% above percentage of yield we will get. Okay, so here more acidic proton also cannot affected on the adjacent groups or catalyst. Okay, so this is the general reaction. Now the fifth case, so here pyridine, 3-iodopyridines which are treated with the terminal alkynes. Now it produces like these type of compound CH2 8 times OH, CH2, 8 times OH. Again, now we have looked out another some of the problems regarding to the sonar-acidic coupling. Let us solve some of the problems regarding to the sonoxyra. Now here it is a terminal alkyne. So here the complication, bromine and fluorine are present among these two. So the general reactivity order, iodine is greater than that of so triflate. Both are equal, but iodine is more reactive to over than the triflate. So general thing, bromine like a chlorine, fluorine. So among the fluorine and bromine, so which is more reactive towards the like a cross coupling reaction, bromine. So now here it is the chemoselectivity of like a different halogens. Bromine readily participates the sonoxyra coupling. Now here it gives a phenyl C triple bond C. Bromine is replaced with the help of our sonoxyra coupling reaction. Now the second example, OCH3Br. So here also it is a terminal alkyne. Here it is the halogen. Now here it creates the new CC single bond. New CC single bond phenyl. Like this OCH3. In eighth example, now here also it is ally, it is the terminal alkane. So they both are coupled together. Now here it gives the cross coupling reaction. Here it is the like a OCH3. Now here COO CH3. So this is the eighth example. Now in ninth example also same, there is no change between these examples, are direct examples. Now here OCH3, like here it gives the C triple bond CH2 5 times, CH3. Now the final example, which is very interesting, here in presence of like large groups, here these are the alcohols originally, so which is protected by the benzoyl groups. So now here OCH2 phenyl. So here these two are also alcohols. So now in the presence of protection groups, now here it undergoes the Sonnagesser coupling. Now it gives their corresponding products. Like here, C triple bond C, here it is OCH2 phenyl, OCH2 phenyl, here OCH3. Now here, this group which is connected to the position of like a halogen attached compound, halogen attached position of the aromatic ring. Now here, so halogen, after the halogen, one position left over, then second position is OCH2. Now one after the second, so OCH2 phenyl. Now again, adjacent position OCH2 phenyl. Now then one after, like we will get the COO. Ethyl, COO methyl, COO methyl. This is the product of the 10th problem. Okay, now let us discuss very important problems regarding to the Sonnagesser coupling reaction. So those are very important. So with the help of Sonnagesser, we will prepare the Bergman cyclized products also. Now let us discuss those products. Now these are the very important problems regarding to the Sonnagesser coupling reaction. Now here, so like a cis compound, so here one of the compound, now they are taking in the only one equivalent. So because of the one equivalent, here only one of the chlorine which is replaced by the like our triple bond. Now here it forms enines, C5H11. So here it retains enough the stereochemistry. Here the Z isomer, it gives the Z as well. Z isomer only. Okay, now in case of second one, here it is the trans compound. So one of the chlorine which is replaced by the our like a Sonnagesser coupling product C5H11. So here retains the stereochemistry E2E. Now in the case of 13, now we would like to take the two equivalents of the compound. That means here it forms the like here R, here also R. So two equivalents, when we will take the two equivalents, now we will get the enediones. Now here it is E9, so here also E9, but here cis-E9, and now here it is trans-E9. Now we will get the enediones. These are the like starting materials of Bergman cyclization products. So in presence of hydrogen donor radicals, now we will get the like these type of product. So here it is the radical. These two are the R groups. Those are the R substituents. So this step are called Bergman cyclization. Or the Bergman paints. Okay. Now here, let us go through the 14th problem. So now here, so two participated groups in Sonnagesser coupling reaction. So first of all, they are treated with alkyne, terminal alkyne silane. Now we will get the product like this. Okay, now here it is the product SIMEH3 in the first case. Now after that, they are used in the another terminal alkyne of alcoholic terminal alkyne. Now we will get the product like this, SIMEH3. Here it is like OR. This is the like a product of 14th one. Now in case of 15th one, so this is the reversal step of the 14th. Now here, first of all, they are prepared OTHF instead of R, they are used OTHP, okay, tetrahydropyran. So then second step, they are getting the like a silane. Okay, now the second, first of all, they are like a, so I would like to write over here. So first step, they are giving the product like this, triple bond. Okay, now OTHP. In the second step, they are used in the same Sonnagesser coupling. Now we will get the product like this. Like here it is OTHP, now here SIME3. So both are similar products. These are the very best examples from very standard books. Now these are the examples regarding to the Sonnagesser coupling reaction. Okay, thank you for